Well, it's took a little while to get some videos out. We're having difficulties with our cameras. We had one break this week. Another one lost the battery, and we can't get a battery for it anymore. This is Buck. And Buck came into us. He's been standing in a pasture for a while, and the owner just purchased him here a while back, and he hasn't had time to work with him, so I'm going to turn him into just a good all-around versatile horse. He's going to rope off him a little bit, do a lot of trail riding, put the rope around him and over him. He did really good with that. Then we come up to the tarp, and the tarp's a different story altogether. Horses think that tarp will eat them. Horses think that tarp will swallow them up. But once they get over it a couple times, then they're going to do pretty good. Now, I work horses over all obstacles at all speeds. Start them at a walk, then move them to a trot, put them over at a lope. I get him going over it on the ground first. I introduce all new obstacles on the ground. I do not put him under saddle and then try to get him to go over something. I like building a horse's confidence on the ground with them. Now this is Max. And I like Max. He's a 5-year-old. He's a Hancock two-eyed jack horse, and he's in training to be a rope horse. We're going to turn him into a heel horse. Now, Max's been ridden quite a bit. He was at another trainer's, but that trainer just worked him mainly on collection, driving him into the bit. Now, being a rope horse, we got to get him used to ropes, and Max has problems with ropes on his hind end. Doesn't like him on his butt or his hind feet. So we got to get him over this. So I just get him moving out. He bucks for a while. The ropes come off. But notice I keep him going forward. I don't just stop him right away. And we just repeat the process until he finally quits. Now what I've done here is I'm just riding him around in my halter. I tie my line up similar to a bocel. And he's kind of tossing his head a little bit. So what I do is I just bump him. We call it doubling. And I get his nose to come down. And what I'm doing here is I'm just kind of getting a feel of him to see how soft he is naturally. I'll do little circles, then I'll ride the full circle, then I'll make straight lines. I'll stop him. I'll bend and send him. And I do this with all the horses. I really like riding them like this at first. And he's doing well. Most of the time when he stops, he does get his hind end under him. He does work off the haunch, which is what you want. We just got to get him over the fear of the rope. I don't know if he's had something in the past where somebody spanked him pretty hard. But we'll get him there. He did a real good turn right there. Now, the training he's had has been good. He just has not had everything done to him. When you put this horse into a bit, and you push him forward and you get him in frame, he does really well. But I want this horse to learn to balance on his own feet, not off my hands. We're turning him into a rope horse. He's got to be able to think on his own. Now this is Shiloh, and Shiloh's doing good for the kind of training she's had. She has a little age on her, and when you have a horse come in for training like this, formal training, they can be a little bit difficult, as in being a little stubborn. It's kind of like that old saying, trying to teach an old dog new tricks. Her owner has not had a whole lot of formal horsemanship training either. All she's done with this mare is just ride her thousands of hours on the trail, but she really wants her to be broke. She wants her to know right leads, left leads. She wants her to know how to stand up. When you work with a horse like this, you have a real break-in period. And what I mean by that is they only want to work just so long, and then it's, no, I want to stop, and I want to go eat, I want to go do my own thing, because that's the way it's always been. Well, now she's in real training, and I push her through that stubborn phase. I push her through that hard part, and in time, they'll learn to work more than just 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Pretty soon they work an hour, and then they'll do an hour and a half. Right here, I'm teaching her a one rein stop. She bends and flexes really good on the ground, but as soon as you get on her, she stiffens up. So we got to work on softening her at the pull, softening her at the neck. And horses do not automatically know the one rein stop. We call it the e-brake, but it isn't like on a car where it's there permanently. Here we have to teach them the one rein stop, and I do that in the round pen. Then when I go out into the arena or I'm outside riding, if something does happen, they're going to know the signal and they are going to stop. So we're just working on her. She's doing really good. She's going to end up being a real nice mare. She has a really nice disposition. We just got to work through that stubborn phase. Now, Chris built the water obstacle. And on Wednesdays, we have trail obstacle class. And I like using this horse. This is Rio. And I really like this horse a lot. He reminds me a lot of Roni. They're built just about the same. Their disposition is very similar. They'll do just about anything for you, but they can turn around and be a pill. But he learns so fast. And the reason why I use him in my lessons and going through my clinics and my schools that I'm having here at the house is everything's new to him. I show people how to go over an obstacle with one of my colts, not a finished horse. I think students get more out of it when I'm showing them how I actually handle a horse. Now there, what I was doing was I was trying to get him to come up and stand and not just want to walk up and over. It's a patience factor thing right here. And he's really coming along really good. I'm real proud of how he's going over all the obstacles. Now I'm riding him in the arena. And again, like I've said in the past, he's been rode a lot, no doubt. He just hasn't had a real solid foundation under him. He is a rope horse, and We will be roping some off of him here. But right here, what I'm doing is I'm just working him in small circles. Then I work him in larger circles. And I'm going to the right quite a bit. The right side is his most difficult side. Now here I do a one rein stop. And he wasn't wanting to listen to me when I first applied pressure. So I had to kind of be a little more assertive. In horses, when you work them for a long period of time in one direction, they do go to sleep. And you have to remember that. So change it up all the time. Now I'm working him around a barrel, and I really like training around a barrel. Visual aid is huge. They can balance off that barrel, see it with their eye. I like to be about 10 feet off of it to start. Now this is Can Do. And Can Do's doing really well. Yes, he's the type of horse that you can just throw the saddle on and go. Like I said before, I had him for 60 days 2 years ago, so he knows the program. I wasn't able to finish him through the program, but he knows the basics. He has a good foundation under him. But I take all my horses, doesn't matter how long they're with me, and I work them on the ground every day. Now we're hooking him up to Smarty. And I am riding him in my Makati setup. So right now he's just in a snaffle bit. And the reason why I'm riding him in the snaffle is I want to be able to move his shoulders, flex him, one rein stop him. And there, see, I'm jerking on him a little bit. I'm trying to get him to rate off. And I don't expect perfection when I'm using this head setup, but I can lift and pull and push and do whatever I need to in that snaffle bit. And I get all my horses to work in a snaffle coming out of the box. That's how I start them. I could take any of my rope horses and rope on them in a snaffle. Now, are they going to be as responsive as if I had them in my normal shank bit? No. But in a snaffle bit, I can get them to be soft. And he's doing good right there. I just did a little steer stop. Now I'm coming out of the box. The camera battery went dead, so we only got one run for that day. But he did good right there. I was proud of him. Now here, see how he's tossing his head a little bit? And he wants to root out. So I put my leg into him. He's getting better. Well, guys, I hope you're enjoying the videos. We got a lot of horses in. We're blessed for that. You take care and ride safe.